Having seen Max Verstappen come through the pack from 20th to finish second in Sochi, it may soon be Lewis Hamilton's turn to have a damage limitation drive from the back of the field. Mercedes had been hoping to avoid taking any grid penalties on Hamilton's car, but it's now looking more and more likely that they will have to take one before the end of the season. There are still 7 rounds to go in Formula 1's longest season ever, and Hamilton has taken his 3 allowed power units for the year. And if he does take another one, he would have to start at the back of the pack, just like Verstappen did in Sochi. This leaves Mercedes with a choice to make. Do they try and make the current power units last the distance, or do they make a tactical switch to prioritise performance and also cover themselves against any other mechanical issues? It's such a difficult decision because if they make the wrong move, it could be game over, especially in a championship that's so finely balanced. Lewis Hamilton has said that he's been trying his best to take care of each engine, but a change may be inevitable at some stage. And if they do take that penalty, where should they take it? Overtaking is possible in both Turkey and Mexico, but these are also circuits that Red Bull expect to suit their car down to a T. If Mercedes makes the wrong choice, it could result in a large point swing in the favour of Verstappen. And if they do take that penalty, there's no guarantee that Hamilton's going to be able to score as highly as Verstappen did in Sochi, given that that result was in some part down to the late rain shower. Verstappen was only on for around a P7 before the shower came, and his timely change to intermediates allowed him to grab that second place opportunistically. Mercedes had originally ruled out changing any parts, with Toto Wolff saying that they were still running very comfortably with the existing power unit and they didn't feel like a change was necessary. But this position seemed to change after Monza and Sochi, where Valtteri Bottas, Hamilton's teammate, was forced to change engine components and start at the back 2 races in a row. Some had suggested that this was done in Sochi to block Verstappen's progress through the pack, which ultimately failed, but this was also disputed by Mercedes after the race, as it appears that they have some genuine concerns over reliability. What's more likely is that Mercedes are trying their best to iron out any engine issues before the engine freeze comes in at the end of the season. All teams need to ensure that their power units are running smoothly and reliability, or they could face more issues once the freeze comes in. We've also seen some of the Mercedes customers suffering with issues over the last few races. Both Williams drivers have suffered pneumatic leaks in previous races, while Sebastian Vettel had an engine failure in practice at the Dutch Grand Prix. The last thing that Mercedes needs is Hamilton suffering any of these issues or these issues carrying over to next season. And this was something confirmed by Wolff in his comments after the Russian Grand Prix, where he alluded to the challenge of balancing this season's performance and next season's reliability. He described it as having a number of balls in the air that will eventually decide what they're going to do next regarding Hamilton's engine. One advantage that Hamilton has had this season is that he hasn't lost any of his engines to issues on the track, unlike both Bottas and Verstappen. Verstappen lost one of his in the clash between the two at Silverstone, while Bottas lost one after his collision with George Russell in Imola. Despite this, Red Bull still seems certain that Hamilton will have to take one at some point this season. Christian Horner has said that he expects there to be a penalty, but that Red Bull can't rely on it. And Helmut Marko has suggested that they have information that suggests Lewis will have to change one in an upcoming race. The biggest headache for Mercedes is now where to take that engine change with the championship so finely balanced. Had Verstappen finished lower in Sochi, Mercedes would have had more breathing room to risk losing points at one of the next races. But Verstappen's second place in Russia really threw a spanner in the works, because it now means that Mercedes would almost certainly risk handing the advantage back to Red Bull should Hamilton have any issues coming through the pack when he takes that penalty. And if he doesn't take a penalty, they risk a mechanical failure or having lower performance because they're having to gingerly get their engines to the end of the season. In hindsight, would they even have preferred to take the penalty in Sochi, as it would have put them on a level playing field with Verstappen? This would have given both drivers the same amount of races on a fresh engine and put Mercedes in a much better position than the one they are currently in. But one thing is for sure, with the title so close, neither of these drivers can afford any more slip-ups, and as Wolff has said, a 0-point weekend would be disastrous for both of them. There's sure to still be many twists and turns to play out for the rest of the season, but it could just be that reliability is the defining factor that comes above all of them. And for Hamilton, the question now seems to be when, not if, he's going to take that engine penalty. Let me know what you think about the possibility of Hamilton taking an engine change in the comments, and if you like this video, please like and subscribe for regular updates from Formula Pulse.